Hello, hello everyone. Today, I'm going to be featuring the tier 9 supercruiser, large cruiser, battle cruiser. Honestly, it seems like every nation wants to call this something different, but the large cruiser Ägir, German tier 9 upcoming premium ship. Before I start though, I do want to highlight that tomorrow is going to be the King of the Sea group stages. We had like almost 5,000 people on my channel watching the qualifiers last weekend, so I expect a lot of people to tune in for the group stages, because now we're gonna see the real top teams and the guys who managed to squeeze through the qualifiers duke it out for a place in the, well, the playoffs. And of course the winners get something like 60,000 steel and 60,000 doubloons, so there's a lot of people really wanting to claim the main prize. Moving on, the Ægir. It sits at 62.3k health, which is honestly not that bad when you consider the Zuma is, what, 58.3, and something like that, Alaska is, what, about 60k, 60.1. So in terms of health pool compared to them, it does quite well. The armor, well, it does have both a good and a bad armor. Obviously, the nose is 27mm, as expected from a large or heavy cruiser. However, it completely lacks any icebreaker, which means, of course, if you push nose in, anything that can overmatch 27mm can just straight up citadel you through the nose. The deck armor is 30mm, once again, same issue. Those big guns, 430 and larger, will be able to overmatch the deck armor. Stern is the same thing, 27. However, where it gets a bit interesting is the upper belt is actually 90mm of plating. Now, this has both up and downsides. The upside is you tend to shatter a ton of HE coming your way at close ranges. Other ships' secondaries, other ships' HE volleys, all of it tends to shatter on this armor belt. However, the issue is that 90mm of plating is so excessive that basically anyone shooting AP on your broadside is going to get full penetrations. So when you give broadside in the Ægir, if they're not citadeling you, they are getting full penetrations. And that means you can eat some absolutely absurd damage volleys whenever you're caught full broadside. It does have a turtleback, but unlike most German turtlebacks, this thing, honestly, it works. It fails more often than it works. It really is not a reliable tool. I've had everything from runes to battleships to all sorts of things capable of citadeling me easily. And once again, if they're not citadeling, they're still scoring full pens. So the hit points of the Ægir are very easily depleted. Kind of Azuma-esque. Unlike the Alaska that has a waterline citadel, this thing does extend quite a bit above the waterline. The armor belt is about 190mm, and then it's got another layer. The citadel itself got like 45 to 60mm. So fairly tanky, but if you're broadside, you're eating a lot of damage in this thing. The main guns, well, in this case, when I say the main guns on the Ægir, I'm actually surprisingly talking about turret guns, and they are probably the least effective main guns I have seen on pretty much any tier 9 cruiser in the game. Early on, I tried to build the Ægir based on the main guns. Basically, these 305mm guns, they have a 22 second reload, which is obviously pretty damn hefty, 865 meters per second shell velocity, and a pretty fast turret traverse time of 25.7 with the captain belt. I really, really, if you put the reload mod on, you can get it to what, something like 19 second reload. And I really tried to make this ship work using the main guns, and it abysmally failed. It just doesn't work. The range is 17 kilometers as well, it was nerfed recently. But the main guns on the ship are complete trash most of the time. It is very hit and miss. You can get the kind of citadels that you're seeing me land on, something like a, well, broadside Neptune, not exactly the hardest ship to citadel, but then you can alternatively also shoot ships that are right in front of you and you land maybe 2 out of 6 guns. You probably noticed the absolutely abysmal back turret firing angle as well. Using the back turret basically means giving broadside, and as I just mentioned earlier, giving broadside in the Ægir gets you absolutely annihilated most of the time. So You're stuck using the front guns with very wonky German dispersion. Of course, unlike the Alaska, you have no improved penetration angles or no sort of super pen there. The main guns are, to put it quite simply, most of the time, they are absolute trash. However, the guns that have proven incredibly useful are the secondaries. You have 9x2, aka 9 turrets with 2 guns each, of 128mm guns. Now these guns, even without specking IFHE, these guns are capable of penetrating 32mm of armor. And add into the fact, because you don't need to spec IFHE, and if you put the flags on, am I even running the flags? I think I'm running the flags, and I get about a 6% fire chance. But basically, you throw out so many secondary shells that you end up causing a ton of fires. That Dizuma, for example, I'm gonna show you how much damage I did to him with my main guns and my secondaries at the end of this match. And I'm pretty sure you're gonna be pretty surprised about just how much work my secondaries put in on that guy. Add in the fact that the secondaries actually have the Graf Zeppelin dispersion pattern, which means, of course, that the secondaries are absolutely incredibly accurate. So, once I gave up on the main guns, basically completely lost cause, the turtleback isn't reliable, if you give broadside you eat massive penetrations in basically all ranges, the concealment is 13.2, not exactly special to put it lightly. Once I gave up on trying to use the main guns in any ways, and just fully, absolutely fully, when I say fully committed to the secondaries, I mean I'm literally running not just the secondary battery mod instead of battery dispersion, but I'm even running the 3 million secondary upgrade instead of the main gun reload upgrade. That's how committed I went to the secondaries, because they are just straight up, they are better than your main guns. This isn't something like in Massachusetts, where both your main guns are good, and then like the secondaries are kind of the cherry on top. This is straight up, the secondaries are the main armament. You shouldn't even play around your main guns. I mean, you can try, but ultimately it's more important to get your secondary guns on the target. It does have torpedoes, 2x4, standard German ones, 6k range, they do 65 knots, they hit for about 14k. It gives you some additional YOLO potential, or more importantly, when you're pushing into secondary range, if someone tries to YOLO you, well, you can punish them with those torpedoes. The AA is pretty okay, mostly because of the build you use, you end up getting a fair amount of continuous damage. In fact, my medium range is like almost 500 on my Ägir, just because of the build that I'm using, the 3 million mod boosts the AA so much. And the flak explosions turn up pretty obscene as well, because captain build wise, I also spec AFT, once again, very much for the secondaries. When I say I build fully for secondaries, I literally mean I don't have concealment expert on this thing. That's why the concealment is 13.2. You can get it better. So I should specify that the concealment can be to get down to, what is it, 11 point... Okay, don't quote me on that. Actually, I can do a real fast switcheroo to get an idea of where we can get the concealment. We can get the concealment down to... Unos segundos. I don't want to be talking out of my ass, rather be talking actual details. If you build for full concealment, you could get it down to 11.9. Oh, I was correct when I started with 11. But ultimately, as I mentioned before, building the ship for secondaries is just so much more useful than building it for any sort of concealment or tankiness. I also don't have fire prevention on it, and considering it's a battle cruiser, it obviously means you have longer duration fires on the ship as well. So overall, this build is quite risky, and it's not that easy to play, because your nose can get overmatched, your stern can get overmatched, if you give broadside you get punished, you don't have a whole lot of concealment, fires can shred you, but good lord, this build is fun. I hated the Ägir. I went from completely despising the Ägir to basically refusing to play it on stream to enjoying it greatly. The speed is 35.2, that's with the speed flag. It's got an 880m turning circle, not really that good. You get a rudder shift time of 11.2, and note that's running the rudder shift module on it, so the handling, not that good either. Air detectability without concealment expert in 9.7, so you basically get spotted from the moon as well. So, pushing in in the Ägir into a situation where you can actually utilize these secondaries can be exceptionally difficult at times. I've had games where I've struggled to really get anything done, because the second you're forced to rely on your main guns, basically you're forced to stay away, you're forced to maintain your distance, you can't get into secondary range. The Ägir is basically hands down, in my opinion, the worst tier 9 cruiser. And I'm including the likes of Neptune, Seattle, Ibuki. I'm including all of those on that list. When you're forced to use nothing but your main guns, the Ägir is horrendous to play. But the second you get into any sort of secondary range, you can just do so much dumb stuff in this ship. So much absolutely dumb stuff in this ship. Friedrich Grosse is reversing out. Got my guns trained on him. And by guns, I mean I have him selected as a secondary target, but you can't see it. Kind of throwing some of those secondary 305mm shells at him as well, but I only land two shells. But my main guns, aka the secondaries, are really starting to hammer him now, which is obviously the priority. Obviously, if you do have Gunther Luthiens, he's basically made for the ship. And when I say basically made for the ship, it's he can give you a 15% secondary reload buff, and on a ship like this, oh my, does this ship benefit. The Zuma hides behind the island, I try to push him, but he keeps hiding, and this game actually ends with these damage numbers. Now, this is not the only game I'm gonna show. This was just one example of basically pushing in and just letting my secondaries shred everything in front of me. 3 kills, 5 citadels, 314 secondary hits. In fact, if we take a look at the team score, 2,200. This was a full tier 9 game. So this is basically as even of a matchmaking you can get. And that's why I thought this was a good example of what this ship can do when you're perfectly equal. I did say I wanted to show you what I did to that Izuma. And if you look at the detailed report screen, you can see that main battery only 96,000. But my secondaries did 70k and an additional 33k fire damage. And more specifically, looking at the Izuma, I did 13k with my main guns. All of the remaining of that 68k was from my secondaries. So these things can absolutely shred. Well, this was going over the stats. Let's show you guys a gameplay example of just how much fun you can have in this thing. In this game, a cyclone has struck and I'm pushing into the objective. I get spotted, so I pop Hydro. Note that I'm running the Hydro consumable, the duration booster. I know the DDs are somewhere down south, so I turn in towards the south to try to find them. And the Friesland pops up. Shoot my main guns, well, more of a secondaries. I land three shells, but honestly, those are not the guns we care about, are they? At this point, I'm just gonna turn away. I'm no longer interested in that Friesland. He's within my Hydro range, and he's within my secondary range. So I know my secondaries are going to shred that destroyer. That improved dispersion means that these guns basically eat destroyers for breakfast. It's absolutely brutal. Even at long ranges, they are extremely accurate and they're very good at tracking the target. Now, I play a bit of a greedy play here. I want to rush, I want to hunt down this Nagata, but the Nagata actually ends up being killed. So I decide, let's speed it up a bit. I decide to turn back and try to secure that C objective instead. My team kind of pushes into their spawn though, and as you can see, it's 7:30 about remaining in the game, and even though we do have a points advantage, we do have a Kappa disadvantage. My Colorado is giving full broadside to a Kronstadt on the other side of the map, and my Gneisenau now is all alone. So this game is suddenly about to turn into a full-on throw. Now, my DD behind me can easily camp B just by sailing through it. I'm gonna try to close the gap into C as quickly as possible and see if I can catch this Zara off guard. Fighting other cruisers in this thing, with this secondary build, in a cyclone, it's pretty damn amusing. And you're gonna get an example of it once we bump into this Zara. He pops up, he's full HP. I obviously instantly select him as my secondary target, and I turn enough to give my secondaries a firing angle. Note that if you go nose in, they can't fire, so you have to give a bit of broadside. He shoots Sap, and does a fair bit of damage, and I just hold my fire. Once he sees how much damage my secondaries are doing, which basically once they start shredding him, he's gonna either panic, turn away, or he's gonna go for the Torps. And he's going for the Torps, giving enough broadside, and at this range, well, even Ægir's guns are effective at this range. I turn in, because obviously, and I slow down a fair bit, because obviously I expected him to torpedo me, because that's kind of what they tend to do in these situations. The torpedoes pop up, and I manage to dodge them. We are down one ship this game. Not the end of the world, but obviously it's going to make the game more difficult for us, especially since we are losing A, no one is within range to defend it, and we don't have C control. I do have Hydro ready though, and I do have my damage con ready, so might as well push in and see what's going on. They have a Myoko here, they got a Colorado, they got, was it an Alsace here, they also got a Yugoma. Obviously Yugoma is the one that scares me the most, especially as Cyclone is passing. If I do get detected and I don't spot the enemy ship, I'm gonna Hydro, because I'm gonna assume that it's possibly the Yugoma that is hunting me on this flank. I got spotted, and that prompts me to pop my Hydro in response. It turns out it was only the Myoko. Note that Gunther Luthien's procs, because I spotted different ships. I set my secondaries on the Myoko, because he's the squishier target, and I just angle myself in towards the Colorado. I'm hoping to slow down in time to let the Alsace just glide past. I don't want the Alsace to get my broadside, because that could hurt a fair bit. Obviously, he's incapable of dealing too much damage, just nose into me, but if he catches my broadside with those big guns, it's really going to hurt. Luthien's procs, I land a citadel, what looks like through the nose of that Myoko, and I just start reversing. I am under a lot of pressure though, because it looks like this Alsace is also a secondary build, and we can see a lot of shells coming in from him, as well as the Colorado. Well, Colorado's big guns obviously have no issues of dealing with that nose. Alsace gives me broadside. Main guns don't really do a whole lot, but amusingly, Aditi has smoked up as he went into the cap behind me. And this is where you can pull off some pretty funny memes. In this case, I stop shooting, because why would I? The Yugoma doesn't appear to be here, we haven't seen any Torps yet, and I'm perfectly safe inside a smoke. If I don't shoot, they can't spot me, and as I mentioned, what you usually do more damage with when you play the Ægir with this build is actually the secondaries, not the main guns. So I just make sure I give enough broadside that my secondaries can keep firing, and I just let them farm. I've done, what, 152k damage, turning enough broadside so all my secondaries can shoot on this guy, and now I just sit back. I got 48 seconds of farming time to enjoy. Maybe we'll get a few fires, maybe we won't. I don't really care. Alsace has 32mm of plating, which means my secondaries have absolutely no issues of penetrating his armor with, well, significant ease. He turns away, he doesn't like what he's experiencing. Colorado keeps pushing in. I could switch to him, but I need to give more broadside to get my guns on him. Yugoma pops up in front of me, but more importantly, a Tashkent starts shooting behind me. And you actually have more secondaries in the back than you have in the front. So I select him as my secondary target. And as I mentioned, DDs plus these secondaries, it's completely ridiculous. He basically instantly starts being completely shredded. He tries to accelerate, tries to run away. I've broken his engine by the looks of it with these secondaries. And I throw in a back turret volley. And he also gets killed off. The game ends. That was an unofficial Kraken, 10 fires, 4 citadels, 241 secondary hits. Detailed report-wise, well, team score-wise, I topped the scoreboard, but that's not too important. More important is, of course, the detailed score. And this time, we actually kind of tied main gun and secondary, and that's probably because I used my main guns a fair bit once they actually gave me broadside, and probably because I was fed, I got to blap a lot of tier 7 cruisers. When you're not up-tiered, or when you're not top tier, you will struggle to use them as much. You know what? We can do one more sped up example of some of this dumb stuff. This is a game where I'm up tiered into tier 10. I see a Friesland securing the A camp. I ask for intelligence data, and I ask for a smokescreen. Now trust me, this is not always going to work, but sometimes you get that amazing checkmark sign, which means he's up for it. He's like, yep, you know what, sure, let's go for it. And let's speed up a bit here. As I enter the camp, I get radared, I get shot at a fair bit, I shoot back, but once the radar runs out, this is where we stop firing. Well, actually I'm still detected, so we gotta reverse back into our smoke, and we got what, 23k damage? And we're using our main guns, or what you might call Ägir's main guns. We can speed this up a bit, and you can look at just the damage meter, the hits. I get spotted eventually, the Conqueror keeps trying to farm me. I kinda don't care. This ship really doesn't care. And we are up at what, over 200 secondary hits. Sadly the Des Moines steals the kill, but that Conqueror just got absolutely farmed to death. The Ägir is hilarious. Let me show you guys my recommended build for the ship. Honestly, the only viable build in my opinion. Try to play this ship with main guns and you're gonna hate it. Use this build and suddenly it's an absolute meme fest. Let me show you guys what I'm talking about. Right, keep in mind that this ship is of course still work in progress. It might get changed a fair bit before release. But this is so far, by far, my recommended build for the Ägir. Premium damage con, you're gonna need it. Premium heal, you're gonna need it. And premium hydro, incredibly important. And of course, it's that German cruiser hydro, which means 6 kilometers of range, which is so very effective. Upgrade-wise, turret and torpedo tube survival. You might go for the secondaries, but these things actually break a ton. I'm afraid to spec out of it because I'm already losing the turrets all the time and giving up that much survivability. Yeah, we build fully for secondaries, but at that point, I think you're crippling yourself too hard. Because every time you turn your guns to shoot something, well, we can look at the armor of the guns. It's fairly good when they're angled, but the surface is very flat. But once you give broadside and you give them this flat, large surface, or you give turret broadside, that is, these things tend to break all the time. So I actually think, even though I love the secondary build, I do think main armaments is pretty mandatory on the Ägir. Plus, it helps keep your torpedo tubes alive, which can be quite useful for those YOLO situations. Hydro duration, secondary battery mod for that range and dispersion. Faster rudder shift, you could potentially build acceleration and tankiness as well, but this is more for the early game as you're trying to find your way in and trying to avoid giving that flat broadside to enemies. Concealment. And finally, auxiliary armaments mod 2, which gives you a huge buff to your secondaries in terms of reload, and of course boost your AA a fair bit. Before I move on to the captain build, I can show you the armor, show you the things I was talking about. 27mm nose, if you go nose in like this, this is a whole lot of surface to overmatch, and there's no battleships that's gonna miss it. And your citadel is right behind it, so that's very easy nose in citadels. Deck armor 30mm, once again, pretty damn vulnerable. Then we got the peculiarity, which is the 90mm armor belt. Great when angled, great against HE, not great when any sort of AP shooting. This is basically one large area where anything can shoot and they will not get overpens. That's terrifying. Add in the turtleback, which doesn't actually work. And a huge ass citadel right behind that turtleback. And as you can see, it's significantly above the waterline. So this thing can absolutely get blapped very, very hard, very, very easily. Keep that in mind as you play it. Captain build-wise, Gunther Lutyens is fantastic if you have it for this perk alone. 15% boost on main on secondary reload is amazing. Build-wise, priority target. I guess you could also go preventive, especially since you got improved preventive. Not a bad choice. I just love this so much because it tells me when people are torping me. And if I'm pushing into a flank, it also tells me how many ships I'm pushing into, which is usually a pretty good warning sign. If the number says 8, that's when you hit the S key and you try to get into cover. Adrenaline Rush, BFT, manual secondaries. I would probably go Superintendent. Actually, no, let's go. You go advanced firing training first. Then you go Superintendent for that additional heal and hydro. Note that you only have 4 of them. And then Expert Marksman for that faster turret traverse. So you get those turrets to a pretty damn snappy 25.7. There is some variation, I think, going for preventive, but ultimately I think these things are so very important. And because these 128mm guns already pen 32mm, you don't need IFHE in this build. Flag-wise, oh, let me show you guys the premium camo. This is the premium camo. Oh, there's no variations, actually, of it. Oh, looks pretty good. I mean, in general, German ships tend to look pretty damn good in this game. And signal-wise, speed, close the distance, secondary flag, absolutely. Fire chance, yes, for your secondaries. Oh, I'm not running detonation flag. Wow, I've been so lucky I haven't detonated. Reduced fire duration, especially since you don't have fire prevention. This thing is very important. And better heal. Add in the faster consumables and the AA. I mentioned that with this build, you actually end up with some really absurd damage on your flak, 2.1k, as well as some pretty damn good continuous damage. Probably not enough to defend yourself against any carriers, but hey, it looks impressive until a conqueror shoots at you once. I hope you guys enjoyed this preview of the Ägir. As this is a good German ship, or at least a fun German ship, I have no doubt Wargaming will go out of their way to nerf it. So when that happens, you can subscribe to my channel as a thank you for killing what could have been a really fun ship. I'll talk to you guys later. Have a fantastic rest of the evening.